Hey everyone, I'm Andy Asher. I'm the editor at Bloomer Boomer, and I interview amazing, smart thought leaders and experts on just about anything and everything, from the crazy to the normal. So what we're going to be talking about today is if you are the right age, and it's about how your phone is probably buzzing like crazy from telemarketers and robocallers. I mean, mine just today has gone off at least three or four times, and it's every year at this time. Why? Well, today's guest has an answer or maybe a solution. He is Alex Enabnit. Alex, it is great having you here today to answer some of our questions.
Thanks, Andy. It's good to be here.
You are with the company eligibility.com that aims to explain all the different benefit programs and services available to us by our local, state, and federal government. Now, Alex, that is one big challenge. And anyway, I think you know what I'm talking about. Literally, my cell phone app that I have on here has intercepted telemarketer calls this morning. And you know, I'm talking about that on a regular basis this time of year. Now, I think you know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's annual enrollment right now. So this is the time when typically beneficiaries get hit very hard with marketing, with calls, just everybody trying to get business. So this is the time of year where it's a popular time to be soliciting service.
Boy, I'll say it's it's coming. It started probably a month ago, and it continues, and it'll probably continue right on through. And we can talk about that part of it a little bit. So Medicare can be really confusing, and while we try to make it as simple here today as possible, we'll only be able to really scratch the surface. But why can't someone crack down on all these marketing calls?
Well, it's an interesting thing to talk about because really, there's so many rules and regulations regarding marketing of Medicare material specifically. It's like CMS has a whole document, just pages and pages long of marketing rules. But something that I find really confusing is that if a company will adhere to the rules, they're not supposed to call you unless you give them permission to market to you. So if you're getting calls out of the blue randomly marketing Medicare Advantage plans or some sort of Part D plan or someone pretending to be from Medicare, it might be a bit of a red flag. So something else to be aware of is you really cannot trust your caller ID anymore. And it's unfortunate, but what a lot of scammers are doing is they're actually able to spoof numbers and pretend like they're coming from Medicare, from the Social Security Administration, where in fact they could be calling from anywhere in the world. So if you're ever in doubt and you're getting a call, first of all, say like, hey, if it's a marketing thing and you don't want to be called, just say to be put on the do not call list. If you still get calls from that same person, from that same company, you could probably report them to 1-800-MEDICARE or the FTC. They handle a lot of those complaints.
Well, good advice. Yeah. You know, and there, here's something else. Whenever I see such aggressive marketing, it seems to tell us a lot about the business. So what it tells me that there must be a lot of money out there if all of these companies are so aggressively trying to get our business.
Absolutely. And nobody likes pushy sales. I mean, that's not something that is enjoyable for anyone. No. I mean, I can't even imagine the salesman likes doing that. So if you're encountering some pushy tactics, there's no reason to go try to partner with that person. You don't have to do that. Like it's really best to make your own decisions for your healthcare, because there's certainly a lot of money in the industry. And if you have valuable information, someone's going to try to get it from you. So it's best to do your research and figure out the plan that's best for you. Listening to marketing tactics.
For sure. And one other thing too, like everything today, there are good companies and there are bad companies. Any way to tell the difference between, say, the good and the bad?
Yeah, I mean, I would say as a blanket statement, the good companies will follow the rules. They'll adhere to the CMS guidelines. They won't use pushy tactics. And they will really give you a balanced opinion. In my personal opinion, I think the best company is the one that tells you what's best for you, regardless of how that affects their bottom line. So for instance, I mean, I write reviews for Medicare Advantage Part D plans, and it doesn't matter to me what company we're partnered with. if you end up finding the right plan, even if it's not something that, we get a benefit out of, I'm happy. And I just want whoever reads from eligibility.com to get the right service for their needs.
Yeah, well, now during this time that we're talking about Medicare Advantage and the prescription drug plans, I know you warn us against the scams. And I mean, what are some of those scams that that you've seen?
Yeah, most of the scams today seem to be imposter scams. So it's people, like I mentioned, calling from numbers that seem to be official, seem to be legitimate. And they say, hey, I'm from Medicare and we're suspending your benefits unless you wire us money, get us gift cards. And first of all, huge red flag. If you're ever asked to pay by wire transfer to a government agency or gift cards to a government agency, hang up immediately and report that to the FTC, because that is fraud. And that's the biggest one today is imposter scams. People pretending to be from Medicare, and it transcends Medicare too. It's the Sheriff's Department has a warrant for your arrest. The Social Security Administration is suspending your benefits, and it's always this kind of like a threat to you, or it could be a promise of free benefits. Another big scam is this free genetic testing. Right now, a lot of scammers are calling people saying, hey, Medicare has approved this DNA test for you, and it's totally free of charge. So just give us your Medicare number, give us your Social Security number, and we'll perform this test for you. Most of the time, that's a total scam, and people don't even get the results back.
Well, you know, and that kind of also raises another question, you know, going back to my earlier question, I guess you might say that the money must be pretty huge for these companies that sometimes breeds the greed and unscrupulous businesses that we need to look out for. It is a red flag.
Sure. Yeah, it's a big problem. And that's why eligibility.com, we publish a scam report. The FTC also has a scam report, which I would encourage anyone who is in Medicare and of Medicare age to be updated on that scam list, because scammers are clever and they're always going to be thinking of something new. Once the government cracks down on a scam, they'll try to think of some other way to get you away from your money. So it's really important to stay up to date on what's out there.
Tell us what this time of year is, because it's well known in the Medicare field, or at least in Medicare Advantage and so on. There's a period of time in which people register, and I know it's complicated, but maybe you can just touch upon it so maybe people get a little better idea and put this into perspective better.
Sure, yeah. The annual enrollment period, which we're in right now, it starts October 15th and runs until December 7th. And this is the time when anyone with original Medicare can say, I want to try out Medicare Advantage. They can switch to Medicare Advantage, or vice versa. People in Medicare Advantage say, you know what, I don't like the way my plan is going next year. They read maybe their benefits notice and how things are changing, and they say, you know what, I think I'm better with original Medicare. I'm just going to go to that and maybe get a Part D plan, something like that. So this is really when most people can make changes in their plans. And it's really the best time of year to look at your current benefits, look how they're serving you. And, by this time, if you're an Advantage plan, your plan should have sent you details on how your plan is changing next year. So you can decide now if you want to stick in that plan or if you want to switch to an original Medicare with maybe Medigap or Plan D.
Well, again, it is complicated and we won't be able to cover it all right here, but that is good information. And before I let you go, what final takeaway can you share with us so that we get it right and that we don't get scammed?
Yeah. And I would say, just as a general statement, if someone calls you out of the blue and they say they're from the government, they're probably not. Typically, the government always gives you a first notice or some sort of first notification and communication through the mail. They're big fans of snail mail, so they won't try to call you and just shake you down for gift cards or money. So if you're getting a call like that, it's probably fake. So just as general advice, I would say lead with your gut. If you're getting some sort of feeling like, oh man, this doesn't feel right, like I don't feel like a Social Security Administration should be calling me and shaking me down for money, it's probably a scam. I would say just be skeptical, have a healthy dose of skepticism, but also, verify and really stay ahead of the curve on what scams people are doing, because as people get scammed, they'll report it to the FTC, and then you can see just the list of current tactics that scammers are using to try to trick you. So I would just say, stay informed, be a little skeptical of phone calls especially, and when in doubt, just hang up the phone, and you can always call back the number that they're saying to be from. So if they say they're from Medicare, you can hang up the phone, call 1-800-MEDICARE and say, hey, I got a call about this. Is this real? Can you direct me to this person? And typically the first person on the line will tell you, hey, that's a scam. I will help you report that. Let's get this taken care of. And don't worry about that charge.
All right. And before I let you go, why don't you give us a shout out for eligibility.com?
Yeah, eligibility.com is a great place for you to find the right Medicare coverage for your needs. So whether that's enrolling in a Medicare plan, finding a Medicare Advantage plan, comparing what's out there, we're really just trying to help you find the best coverage for your needs. So happy to help you however we can. My colleague and I, Catherine, she wrote this whole guide on Medicare scams. So she's very well informed. I am as well. We're happy to help however we can.
Well, beautiful. Thank you so, Alex, so much. That's Alex Enabnit with the company eligibility.com that aims to explain all the different benefit programs and the services available to us by our local, state, and federal government. I want to say to you, take care, and we will see you next time.